This is my first installment of a Scaling Scrum video series, and today we start with Large Scale Scrum. What is it? Why use it? How is it different from the Scrum framework and other scaling methods and frameworks? First off, let's define LESS, which is a multi-team Scrum framework which can be applied to a team of 12 people or even a team of hundreds of people all working together on a specific shared product. The framework is extremely simple compared to other scaling frameworks. There's less enforcement on roles, artifacts, and processes. Very similar to Scrum, the teams are cross-functional agile teams, meaning that they have all the skills, all the knowledge, all the competencies in order to build this shared product together. That's what a cross-functional team is. There's two versions of LESS. The basic LESS, 2 to 8 teams, and LESS huge, more than 8 teams. 3 roles, same as Scrum, 3 roles in LESS for product owner, for Scrum Master, and the developers. The product owner maintains a single product backlog with many product backlog items, which multiple teams, Scrum teams, work on the same backlog. That's the key difference here. A single product backlog, multiple teams working on a single product backlog, not multiple teams working with their own product backlog. No, that's not LESS. That's something else. In LESS, a single product backlog, multiple teams working on this product backlog. That's the specific shared product. Let's quickly go through this simple image, which is broken down into 3 sections. Top left, product vision and direction, that's the product owner. Then there's the product creation and delivery, the teams. And bottom section, organizational capability and improvement, that's the managers. New role, Scrum Master. We already know what a Scrum Master is, but there's a new role, the managers. You can pause this video to go through the role of a product owner and the teams. By the teams, we mean the developers, both top right and top left. Same thing, very similar to how Scrum works. Now, let's talk about the Scrum Master. Same thing, coach organization, support, continuous improvement. What does the Scrum Master do on the Scrum framework? Same thing. So let's now talk about this new role. Managers improve capability of development system, decide structure and policies. The managers in the LESS framework, way different from our traditional managers, deciding what to work on, who does what, assigning tasks, setting deadlines. No, not these kinds of managers. These managers do something very specific, design the structure and policies and improve the capability of a development system. In a nutshell, working with the Scrum Master, the product owner, the teams to teach them how to improve, how to fix problems and also resolve impediments. Basically, help them build great products. So what about the sprints? The sprint planning, the sprint retrospectives. Let's start with the sprint. Same thing as the Scrum framework. You can do a sprint of 1 week up to 4 weeks, but there's a key difference. Scrum doesn't talk about any specific start date or end date. There's nothing mentioned concerning that in the Scrum Guide, the latest version, the Scrum Guide 2020. But in LESS, all the teams need to have the same start date for the sprint and the same end date, which makes sense because everyone is working on a shared product. The daily Scrum event is also very similar. Each one of these teams do their own daily Scrum. If you want to attend one of the team's daily Scrum, you just attend and observe. Obviously, you don't participate in the daily Scrum. Nothing changes here. Concerning the sprint review, same thing, same structure, same goal, but a single sprint review because, again, we are working on a shared product backlog, a single product backlog, so it would make sense. But we start the sprint, same date, we end the sprint, the same date, and we do a single sprint review. Then there's a product backlog refinement activity, same goal as in Scrum. We want to get things ready, user stories ready, tasks ready, so that the developers can start working on them. But quite different because there's multiple teams involved, all working on a single product backlog. Add some complexity. That's why LESS, the framework, comes with some recommendations that you don't need to use, just recommendations. You can use them if you want. We won't go through that in this video. We don't have time for that. Check the description of this video if you want more details on how the refinement changes in the LESS framework. Then there's the definition of ready, the definition of done. Same thing as for Scrum. all the teams working on a single product backlog have their own definition. So all the teams have a similar definition of done, similar definition of ready, because again, they are working on a single product backlog. Next is the sprint planning. That's a little bit different. Remember, the sprint planning, we are working together to plan the sprint. We want a sprint goal, a commitment in terms of user stories, in terms of sprint goal, in terms of story point. But the team will work together to achieve by the end of a sprint. There's two phases to sprint planning in Less. The first phase, each team comes with two developers, two people from the team, and meet their product owner to talk about high priority items. They start picking items, high priority items from the product backlog. Who will work on what? Which teams will work on what? And then the second section of the sprint planning, they go back to their teams and they start working with their teams, estimating work, ensuring that the items are ready, contacting the product owner if ever they need more clarifications concerning the user stories. Very similar to a traditional sprint planning session as seen in the Scrum framework. And then we all come together to start the sprint. Again, each team's similar start date and end date. They own their own sprint, their own product backlog items, a single backlog, but they work on different things. Obviously, not everyone is working on the same thing. So we all come together and start the sprint. We pick a sprint goal, we make a commitment, and we work together on this shared product. And the last event, the sprint retrospective, very similar to Scrum. Each one of these teams will do their own sprint retrospectives, and we also do a single sprint retrospective with everyone working on the product backlog. Everyone will be invited, even the managers. Well, we'll talk about impediments. How can we improve the processes? Same as a sprint retrospective, a typical, a traditional sprint retrospective, but with everyone, all the teams working on the single product backlog. And that's a lot of people in the single sprint retrospective. Just imagine if you have 15 teams, and because of this, each team might send their own representative, maybe one person or two people from each team, and we all meet together for this big, huge sprint retrospective. And that's it. That's all the Scrum events in Less. Same thing. If you do the Scrum events well, with the slight differences that Less brings, you should be able to follow the Less framework and make it work for you. And the last thing that I want to talk about is all about integration. The work of all the teams must be integrated before the end of every sprint. The integration must be done during the sprint. The Scrum framework doesn't talk about that. If you read the Scrum guide, there's no mention of integration, which makes sense because they tell you Scrum. You don't need to be in a development environment to use the Scrum framework. Obviously, not everyone will be integrating things together, but usually, when you're working on a product, when you have dependencies with other teams, obviously you'll be integrating the work. So most Scrum teams, not even using Less, most people who use the Scrum framework are already doing this integration part, which they mention in their definition of done. The Less framework only mentions it, tells you that everything needs to be integrated. Every sprint, everyone, so that obviously we can release this increment, this shippable increment of a product. So that's it for Less. Very simple to understand, very close, very similar to the Scrum framework. I would even say there's a scaling framework, which is the most similar to the Scrum framework. It's Less. That's why I highly recommend it. If you have a single team using the Scrum framework and you want to scale it to a few teams, start with Less. You'll easily integrate in the Less framework because it's so simple to understand. You're using the same Scrum events with some slight changes, which brings me to my next point. If you want more tips, insights on Agile Scrum personal growth, click on the video that stands out the most on the screen right now, and I'll see you in a few seconds.